In this lesson, we're going to be going over using Nessus to do vulnerability scanning. You can see that I'm logged in here to the Nessus web interface, and through this web interface, you can do all of the management of Nessus and start your scans and configure your scan policies. You can see here I've got a test scan running against the system, and I'm doing that in order to cut off some time here so I can show you a report once the scan is completed. In the meantime, let's go off and take a look at the different policies and how you would build a policy in order to do scanning against systems. You'll see here there are four policies that are in place, and these are ones that have been distributed by Tenable, and they're just built into Nessus. You can create new policies, you can modify the ones that are there. Let's do an add a policy here and call it my policy. It's a private visibility, and I'm just going to add a description saying my policy for testing purposes. So you can see the different types of settings here under just the general tab. So for scanning, I want to do safe checks, which means I don't want to do anything that could potentially take a system down. If you were doing testing against a system where it didn't really much matter whether you knocked it over or not, you could uncheck this. Let's do an uncheck here. I want to log scan details to the server, so all of the scan details are going to be logged on the Nessus server. I can avoid sequential scans, I can consider unscanned ports as closed. I'm going to leave the TCP scanner off and just use a SYN scan. I'm not going to do a UDP scan because it takes a really long time. An SNMP scan, we're definitely going to do. We're going to check for SSH. We're going to ping. I'm going to change the default port scan range from the usual to 0 to 65535, which is all of the ports that are available. Under credentials, I can change Windows credentials or SSH credentials. As mentioned previously, if I add credentials, Nessus will log into the system and check for local vulnerabilities. You may want to do that type of thing if you're doing a white hat hack or an ethical hack where you've got complete cooperation from your target and they provide you credentials. This is a really useful thing to do, and just have Nessus run the local scans for you. So again, I can do Windows SSH. If you've got Kerberos configuration, you can do that. Here's some clear text protocols. So if you're using Telnet or RSH or REXEC, you could have Nessus use credentials for those things as well. Here's all of the plugins. Normally, they would all be enabled by default. So we've got 49,340 enabled plugins. You can disable them as you need based on the type of scanning that you're going to do, but frankly, Nessus is pretty smart about what plugins it runs, so it doesn't have any harm in having all of them enabled. If a plugin doesn't make any sense at all to run, it's not going to. But if you had a specific thing that you were looking for, if you were just going to check databases, you could, for example, disable all and then just turn on databases. So it would check all of the plugins that it had for database vulnerabilities. And go back to enable all though. Now we can go to preferences, and there's a number of different preferences that you can set. You can do an HTTP login page, so if you've got a login page on a web server that you know is out there, you can set the login page and the login form, and the different form fields that are used to do the login, and then set the credentials on that. I can do LDAP checks. There's some login configurations here, different settings for the Nessus SYN scanner and the Nessus TCP scanner, and a wide variety of other things. I can do SMTP settings so we can check things like open relays, SNMP settings. We'll get into SNMP in other lessons, but here's different settings that you can use in order to do some SNMP probing. Web application tests. You can either enable or disable web application tests. I'm going to enable it here in this case. And you can do other different things. I can check for HTTP parameter pollution just to see if I can get the server to do something funny and respond. So I'm going to submit that. And you can see my policy was successfully added. So in addition to the four default ones, there's now my policy. So I want to launch a scan using my policy. So I'm going to go to scans. And you can see the scan that I've already got running here. Looks like it's still running along. I'm going to add one. I'm going to call my scan. I can run it now, or I can do a schedule if I want it to start in the middle of the night when I'm asleep, for example, in order to not interfere with my Netflix streaming from home, or if I want to protect the client and make sure I'm only scanning during a maintenance window, I can set up a schedule. Now I need to select the policy. So we just did the policy, I'm going to do my policy. I could do a targets file, which would be a list of host names or IP addresses in just a text file. You can look for that, or I could just do 192.168.1.22, and I can launch my scan. Go over to reports here, and the test scan is completed. So I can open up my report, and I can see all of the different vulnerabilities that were found. I don't have any high-risk vulnerabilities. I did find that the SSL server certificate cannot be trusted because it's self-signed, and I can pop that open and get a description of the vulnerability and, again, what Nessus says that vulnerability is. And it looks like I found it on two different ports, 1241 and 8834. And I can do the same thing here. That's a self-signed certificate. So as I click down through the different lists here to see what I've got, it has in the middle the host and the port, and if there are multiple ports or multiple hosts, if I were scanning multiple hosts, I would see that. I've got an Apache Tomcat servlet running on port 8080, and Nessus believe that's a medium severity or a medium risk factor. And once I'm done looking at that, I can close it, and we go back to this view here. Looks like I've got IP forwarding enabled, and I've got some informational ones here. The Nessus SYN scanner just came back with the list of ports that it found that were available. It says under Synopsis, it's possible to determine which TCP ports are open. Again, this is simply informational. If you are offering a service, obviously you want that service to be available, so the port should be found to be open when somebody attempts to connect to it. So that's as you would normally expect it to be. If you were to find some ports here that you wouldn't expect to be open, like this 1241 looks like an oddball port to me, and so that may be one that I go take a look at and figure out what it is and why it's open. We can close this down and go back to our list. This displays the SSL certificate. Looks like this is a Nessus certificate. Nessus Users United is the organization. So there's that certificate, 8834. Looks like a Nessus certificate as well. So there's a couple of different Nessus ports that are open, and Nessus found those. So that's the different types of things that you can do with a vulnerability scanner, and particularly with Nessus.